Alhamdulillah wa salatu wa salam ala nabiyyina Muhammad wa ala alihi wa sahbihi wa sallam amma ba'd. Ahabati fillah, the reward of remembering Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is immense. And as we've mentioned in this series, we talked a lot about, or a bit about, those people who are considered the dhakirin wa dhakirat, and that you can remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala often, and you should remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala often in order to have a healthy and clean heart. And Abu Amr ibn As-Salah rahimahullah ta'ala, he was asked about the limit or amount of remembrance one must do in order to be considered one of the men and women that frequently remember Allah the Exalted. He said, if a person constantly engages in the remembrance, the adhkar, that are narrated and established during the morning and the night, as well as during the various times and situations during the night and the day, they will be among the men and women who frequently remember Allah. So, ahabati fillah, if you want to fit that criterion, then learning the adhkar from the sunnah of the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, to know the best times and in the best manners of how to come closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and how to be of the dhakirin wa dhakirat. This comes from following the sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. It comes from knowing and understanding and gaining fiqh of the sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And it comes from learning and memorizing those adhkar of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and learning when he sallallahu alayhi wa sallam made those adhkar. And may Allah tabarak wa ta'ala forgive us of our many, many sins and shortcomings, and bless us with ikhlas with the bat, and bless us to be of the dhakirin. O Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, please forgive us of our many sins. Grant us ilman nafiyah, wa rizqan tayyiba, wa amalan mutaqabbilan. Wa sallallahu wa sallam ala nabiyyina Muhammad, wa ala alihi wa sahbihi wa sallam.